हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मृणाली पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट श्री विले पार्ले केलवानी मंडल्स इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी धुले। स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक एंटी कैंसर ड्रग फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री सेकेंड। द एंटायर कंटेंट ऑफ दिस वीडियो हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक and reference books which are mentioned at the end of video, and author has not claimed whatsoever the images and infographics taken from the internet. This video is made for educational purpose only. The content of this video will include the basics of cell cycle kinetics, which is important to understand before discussion of cancer, introduction to the disease cancer, then causes of the cancer, then types of the cancer, and lastly anti-cancer drugs classification, and in that anti-cancer drug classes, in this video I am going to cover only one category, that is nothing but alkylating drug, the mode of action of alkylating drugs and its chemistry. Let's try to understand a cell cycle kinetics. A cell is undergoing a cell division and cell proliferation by undergoing into the four different phases. The cell cycle division starts with the S phase, that is nothing but a synthesis phase. In first phase of cell division and cell proliferation, in S phase, the DNA should be replicated. Means in the synthesis phase, the replication of DNA takes place. Later on, from S phase, cell moves to the G2 phase. In the G2 phase, additional protein synthesis takes place, including the formation of microtubules and necessary enzymes. After G2 phase, cell enter into the G0 phase, and here in this G0 phase, cell do not prepare for cell division, but it only carry for the normal metabolic processes. Later on, after G0 phase, cell moves to the M phase, which is subdivided into the prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. And in M phase, the DNA is segregated and actual cell division occurs. If you see here, in M phase, you can clearly see the DNA is segregated, the replicated DNA in the S phase is being segregated here in the M phase, and actually the cell division has been occurred. These two daughter cells have been formed. After a cell division, this newly formed daughter cell, they enter into the G1 phase, and in the G1 phase, the enzymes which are necessary for the replication of DNA of this newly formed daughter cells are being synthesized. The entire cell is moved from one phase to another phase by the help of cyclin and its dependent proteins, such as cyclin dependent proteins CDK4 and CDK6. So these are the cell cycle kinetics. Now, what are the important points to understand here? So, without cell cycle kinetic, cell cannot divide and proliferate, and that is very important to understand before discussing a cancer. Now, what do you mean by cancer? Cancer means uncontrolled cell growth or uncontrolled division of abnormal cells in the parts of body. Or in simple language, cancer is defined as uncontrolled cell division and cell proliferation. How it happens? So later on in the slides, we will discuss about the causes and types of cancer. So before cell divides, the DNA is checked to make sure that it has been replicated correctly. If DNA has not replicated correctly, or if DNA doesn't copy itself correctly, a gene mutation occurs, and that gene mutation may serve as a cause for cancer. So uncontrolled cell proliferation consume a significant portion of the body's supply of the food material as well as metabolic energy, and because of this a person become progressively weaker. This is one of the symptom of the cancer. Often the cancer cell separate themselves from the primary tumor, and that primary tumor is carried via lymphatic system, means via blood, and that primary tumor reach to the different site where that divide and it form secondary tumor. So now it is very necessary to understand what tumor means. So tumor is abnormal mass of the tissue which result from the uncontrolled cell division and cell proliferation. Based upon the severity of the tumor, it is classified into two types. First one is a benign tumor, second one is a malignant tumor. Now let's understand the difference between benign tumor and malignant tumor. Benign tumor is the one which do not spread to the other parts of the body. Means you can say benign tumor is restricted to the one part of the body, whereas the malignant tumor is the one which invade or spread to the other parts of the body. Benign tumor cell or benign cancerous cell, they have a slow rate of division, whereas malignant tumor cell has high rate of cell division and cell proliferation. The benign tumor cell, they are closely resemble and they function like a normal cell, whereas malignant tumor cell can be easily distinguished from the normal cell. And the malignant tumor cell, they spread from one part to another part via lymphatic system by forming a metastasis. Metastasis itself is nothing but spreadability of that cancerous cell. Benign tumor cell do not break out of the originating organ, means they are restricted to the originating organ, whereas the malignant tumor cells, they travel through the blood circulation from one organ to another organ or one body part to another body part. That is what the metastasis means. The benign tumor, it can be easily removed by the surgical treatment, whereas malignant tumor is very difficult to treat, and for the treatment of malignant tumor we have various approaches like chemotherapy, radiation therapy and surgery. Let's try to understand the causes of cancer. How this uncontrolled cell division and cell proliferation occurs and what are the reasons behind it. So there are n number of causes of cancer, such as 80 to 90% of cancers are said to be originated from the environmental factor. Now the agent which tend to cause cancer is called as a carcinogen. That carcinogen may be chemicals, addiction, and it may be a such kind of material which will prone a normal cell to have ability to become uncontrolled cell growth and cell division. The causes of cancer include radiation, the long exposure to the X-rays, UV rays and radioactive substances increases the chances of skin cancer. Chemicals such as benzene, arsenic, polycyclic hydrocarbon, if somebody is having a long period of contact with this chemical like benzene, arsenic and polycyclic hydrocarbon, then such kind of person may have chances to develop a abnormal cell division and cell proliferation, and ultimately it is subjected for cancer. Addiction, the habitual tobacco consumption, alcohol and some drugs, they leads to the cancer of mouth, throat, esophagus and lungs. So this addiction also become one of the cause for various cancer. Biological agent include Epstein-Barr virus and human papilloma virus. So because of this agent, certain sorts of cancers have been observed. Dietary factors, consumption of fatty food leads to cause breast cancer within women. Genetical factor, very few cancers are reported to be hereditary, but still 5 to 10% cancers are hereditary, for example, retinoblastoma. And lastly, other agents like pesticide, herbicide, fertilizer, and environmental pollutant, they also causes a different cancers. What are the types of cancer? So based upon the type of cell involved in the uncontrolled cell growth and proliferation, cancer is classified into following type like carcinoma, sarcoma, lymphoma, leukemia, germ cell tumor, and lastly blastoma. Carcinoma is nothing but a cancer of epithelial cell, and the example include breast cancer, skin cancer, and lungs cancer. Sarcoma is nothing but a cancer of connective tissue, and the example is bone cancer. Lymphoma is cancer of lymph node. Leukemia is the cancer of blood tissue and bone marrow, and example of leukemia is blood cancer. Germ cell tumor, this is the type of cancer which is derived from pluripotent cell, and most often it presents the testicles and the ovaries. Whatever the germ cell tumor is there for a testicles, it is called as a seminoma, and germ cell tumor of the ovary is called as dysgerminoma. Blastoma is nothing but a cancer derived from immature precursor cells or embryonic tissue. So this is all about the causes and types of cancer. Let's try to understand anti-cancer drug treatment. The main goal of antineoplastic drug or anti-cancer drug include elimination of cancer cells without affecting normal tissues. But in reality, all the anti-cancer drug or cytotoxic drug, they affect the normal tissues as well as the cancerous malignancies. So chemotherapy is the term which refers to the drugs that are used to kill the cells, and chemotherapeutic agent include both kinds of drugs such as antibiotic drug and the drugs used for the treatment of cancer. But here in this chapter, this chemotherapy term is exclusively used to refer the anti-cancer drug or antineoplastic drug. In simple language, the definition of anti-cancer drug is given as: anti-cancer drugs are those agents or those compounds which are used in a treatment of cancer. Let's try to understand the classification of anti-cancer drug. Anti-cancer drugs are broadly classified into four classes. The first class is nothing but alkylating agent. Second class include anti-metabolite. Third class include antibiotic and DNA complexer drug. Fourth class include microtubule inhibitor drug. So here in this video, I am going to explain alkylating drug as an anti-cancer molecule. In this alkylating drug, I am going to cover nitrogen mustard, aziridine, methane sulfonate ester, and nitrosourea. Let's try to understand about alkylating agent. Now, what do you mean by alkylating agent? The name itself indicate alkylating. Alkylating means the one which have ability to alkylate the another molecule. So alkylating drugs are the class of drug which are capable of forming covalent bond with important biomolecules. Now, what kind of important biomolecules are present within a cell? So in the cell, the DNA and RNA are the important biomolecules present. So alkylating drug majorly shows attack on the nucleophilic site of the DNA and RNA. The major targets of drug action of alkylating agent include the nucleophilic groups present on the DNA, especially the seventh position of the guanine. So there are several potential nucleophilic sites on the DNA and RNA, including amino, hydroxyl, and phosphate, which are very susceptible to an attack by electrophilic center of the alkylating agent. Now, what kind of nucleophilic centers of DNA and RNA are present? So, on the next slide, the major nucleophilic sites on the DNA and RNA have shown. So, DNA and RNA are composed of base pair like guanine, adenine, cytosine, and thymine. So, here in case of guanine, the nitrogen 7, nitrogen 3rd, and nitrogen 2nd are served as a potential nucleophilic site for attack on the alkylator drug. In case of adenine, nitrogen 1st, nitrogen 3rd, and nitrogen 7 serve as a potent nucleophilic site for the attack on the electrophilic center of the alkylating drug. In case of cytosine, nitrogen 3rd is the major nucleophilic site which will attack on the electrophilic center of the alkylator drug. And in case of thymine, nitrogen 1 and oxygen of the ketonic center will serve as a nucleophilic site on the attack of the alkylator drug. Let's try to begin with a subtypes of the alkylating drug. So there are three subtype of alkylating drugs such as nitrogen mustard, aziridine, and methane sulfonate ester. So I am beginning with nitrogen mustard. Now, nitrogen mustard. What do you mean by nitrogen mustard? So nitrogen mustard is the one which have been derived from the World War I. So this nitrogen mustard compound is as similar as that of the sulfur mustard. The bioisosteric replacement of sulfur with that of a nitrogen give a nitrogen mustard compound. So nitrogen mustard include the example like mechlorethamine, which is mentioned here, second structure of chlorambucil, the third mephylan, and the fourth cyclophosphamide. The structures of mechlorethamine, chlorambucil, mephylan, and cyclophosphamide, they can be divided with their substitution like aliphatic and aromatic. Okay, the R group, that is aliphatic and aromatic, determines the chemical reactivity and oral bioavailability as well as side effects of that nitrogen mustard molecule. In case of mechlorethamine, over the nitrogen mustard, aliphatic group is present, that is nothing but methyl group. So aliphatic group increases the electron density on the amino nitrogen and it facilitates the aziridium ion formation. The aziridium ion reacts fast with the DNA and other nucleophilic species and it increases the risk of serious side effects and it lacks the selectivity. So to solve the problem of selectivity as well as side effects due to the aziridine ion formation in case of mechlorethamine, the structure is modified further. In case of aliphatic group, aromatic group is tried and aromatic substitution shown that the aromatic substitution decreases the electron density towards nitrogen mustard molecule and the decreased electron density over this nitrogen slow down the aziridine ion formation. So because of slow formation of aziridine ion formation, the compound with aromatic substitution permits oral administration. It enhances the tissue selectivity and the severity of side effect has been decreased. For support of this point, we can take an example of chlorambucil as well as mephylan, because chlorambucil and mephylan, both drug contains aromatic substitution, and with aromatic substitution the aziridine ion formation has become slow down, and slow formation of aziridine ion formation allowed us to give this drug by oral route. Lastly, in case of cyclophosphamide, the attachment of highly electron withdrawing groups and attachment of highly electron withdrawing group in case of cyclophosphamide prevents the aziridine cation formation until the electron withdrawing function has been altered. Let's try to understand the mechanism of alkylation of nitrogen mustard. So here I have taken this particular diagram from the textbook Wilson and Giswold's textbook of organic medicinal and pharmaceutical chemistry, and this diagram is present on the page number 359 to 360. The description is also given. So in case of mechloroethamine, how the alkylation takes place? So in case of this mechloroethamine, the nitrogen is served as a potent electrophilic center. The mechanism of alkylation involves the attack of nucleophile over the electrophilic drug. In case of cancerous cell, the nucleophilic material serve as adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. So whenever the amino, hydroxyl or phosphate site of the adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine will attack to the electrophilic center, this kind of arrangement will takes place. So first of all, the azridine ion must be formed over there. Once this azridine ion is formed, in situ azridine ion must be formed, the tissue nucleophile from the adenine, from the guanine or cytosine have ability to attack on the electrophilic azridine ion. Once the electrophilic center have been take an attack by nucleophilic center, that is nothing but adenine, thymine or cytosine, this kind of intermediate will be formed. Means first, for the first time, alkylation has been takes place, and the same molecule is subjected for the nucleophilic attack by adenine, guanine and cytosine, and second time the alkylation takes place. It means that the nitrogen mustard have ability dialkylation of the biological molecule like DNA and RNA. So these drugs, this nitrogen mustard, are act as a dialkylator drugs. Because of alkylation, what kind of effect will be observed? Because of such kind of introduction of alkyl groups in between the 3' and 5' base pairs of the DNA, the separation of strand will be prevented, and in the synthetic phase itself, that particular cancerous cell is going to arrest for the cell division and cell proliferation. The next category of alkylating drug include azridine itself. How this azridine has been originated? So by virtue of nitrogen mustard's in situ azridine ion formation, people have tried to make azridine within a lab. So azridine has a well-known example of drug thiotepa. So thiotepa itself contains three well-defined azridine ring systems. So thiotepa molecule incorporates a less reactive azridine ring as compared to which is formed in case of mechloroethamine as shown in a previous slide. So why this less reactive azridine ring is there? So adjacent thiophosphoryl functional group is served as an electron withdrawing one, and therefore it reduces, the thiophosphoryl itself reduces the reactivity of azridine ring system. So because of this electron withdrawing group, whatever the azridine ring system will be liberated, that is less reactive one. And now this azridine cation or azridine electrophile will be served as a target for the nucleophilic attack by the important biomolecules such as DNA and RNA. The nucleophilic center of the DNA like guanine, adenine, cytosine or thymine will have an interaction with a cationic center, which is nothing but the azridine ring. Although the thiotepa is less reactive than many other alkylating drug, but it has been shown to form a cross link between the 3' and 5' base pairs और 3 डैश और 5 डैश स्ट्रैंड्स ऑफ द डीएनए विथ अजिरिडीन विथ थायोटेपा मोनो अल्काइलेशन इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ अजिरिडीन फॉर्मेशन वाया हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ थायोटेपा सो दैट हाइड्रोलिसिस हैज बीन शोन हियर इन द सेकेंड पाथवे द मोनो अल्काइलेशन टेक्स प्लेस एंड फर्दर द डाई अल्काइलेशन इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल इन केस ऑफ थायोटेपा थायोटेपा लास्टली मेटाबोलाइज वाया द ग्रुप ऑफ एंजाइम लाइक CYP2B1 एंड CYP2C11 इन द लीवर एंड द मेटाबोलिक रिएक्शन इज नथिंग बट डी सल्फ्यूरेशन सो इट लिबरेट्स अ एक्टिव मेटाबोलाइट लाइक टेपा एंड दैट एक्टिव मेटाबोलाइट टेपा ऑल्सो हैव कैपेबिलिटी टू अल्काइलेट द डीएनए एंड आरएनए ऑफ ग्रोइंग कैंसरस सेल लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द लास्ट कैटेगरी फ्रॉम अल्काइलेटिंग एजेंट दैट इज नथिंग बट मिथेन सल्फोनेट ईस्टर सो हाउ दिस मिथेन सल्फोनेट ईस्टर हैज बीन डिराइव्ड एज अ अल्टरनेटिव टू यूटिलाइजिंग अजिरिडीन एज अ इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक स्पीशीज इट वॉज फाउंड दैट सिंपली यूटिलाइजिंग कार्बन चेन विच टर्मिनेटेड एट बोथ एंड बाय द गुड लिविंग ग्रुप गेव अ कंपाउंड विच आर कैपेबल ऑफ एक्टिंग एज अ क्रॉस लिंकिंग एजेंट सो इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग अजिरिडीन एज अ इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक साइट वट पीपल हैव डन दे हैव जस्ट मॉडिफाइड द स्ट्रक्चर एंड दे हैव सेपरेटेड दिस 4 कार्बन चेन अपार्ट फ्रॉम ईच अदर बाय अ गुड लिविंग ग्रुप लाइक सल्फोनेट एंड दिस इज हाउ द बूसल्फान इज ओरिजिनेटेड सो बूसल्फान अगेन हैव अ गुड एबिलिटी टू अल्काइलेट द डीएनए So, busulfan utilizes 2 sulfonate functionalities as a living group and they are separated from each other by a 4-carbon chain. The 4-carbon chain actually reacts with the DNA primarily to form intra-strand cross-link at the 5' and 3'. So, specifically, it is observed that busulfan shows alkylation at the guanine and adenine base pair. Again, introducing the intra-strand cross-linking between 3' and 5' and preventing that particular DNA for the replication. If replication doesn't happen, cell will not move further into the next phase. If it is not moved to the next phase, the cell division and cell growth will not take place and this is how the growing cancerous cell will subject for the cell death. Now let's summarize the mechanism of action of the alkylating drug. Alkylating drugs are capable to form covalent bond with important biomolecule like DNA and RNA. They target the nucleophilic group present on the DNA, especially the 7th position of guanine. However, the proteins and RNA they may also be alkylated due to the alkylating agent. Alkylating drug interfere with the separation of the strands and they prevent the process of mitosis or cell division and cell proliferation and ultimately they lead to the arrest of cell division and cell growth of growing cancerous cell. This is how they prove to be anti-cancer drug molecule. For the preparation of this video, I have majorly used the reference Wilson and Giswold's textbook of Organic Medicinal and Pharmaceutical Chemistry, which is edited by the John M. Billay and John H. Block. And the chapter is mentioned over there, Antineoplastic Drug. Page numbers are 355 to 410. Thank you very much.